أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Yes indeed. 1400 years after the events, we still talking about them in the four corners of the earth. And our female Sahabi companion for today is one example. She's one of the millions and billions of human beings who lived on the surface of planet Earth and spent their lives and died, and they are gone from the memory and from the history. But this is not true for the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Or anyone who attached to him and to his principles and his ideals and his message became immortal, became a giant, achieved the highest of his potentials, actualized those potentials, became angel-like. So, Umm Kulthum bint Uqba, who is she? Her father was one of the arch enemies of the Muslims. Even he was more physical than Abu Jahl, and he hurt the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam physically, and nothing would have stopped him. And this she companion accepted Islam despite her family rejection, and she made a hijrah from Mecca to Medina on foot and came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and gave the pledge to be a good Muslim. And here, this happened after Sulh al-Hudaybiyah. Her father sent two of her brothers, Al-Walid ibn Uqba and Umara ibn Uqba, after her to the Medina, and they met with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they asked to take her back. And here the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam realized the situation, and he listened to her, who was an adult, and she is free, and she's a woman. And she told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "O Prophet of Allah, if you send me back those non-believers, the idol worshippers, those the arch enemy of Islam, including her father and brothers, will put me in a big test, and I might become non-believer, and I might be tortured, and I might be killed." And here the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam waited till the revelation came. And the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam how to face this situation and similar ones when the female Muslims are asked to be returned, to be tortured and be killed, that the treaty does not cover them. And the revelation came, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا جَاءَكُمُ الْمُؤْمِنَاتُ مهاجرات فامتحنوهن. سورة الممتحنة. الله أعلم بإيمانهن فإن علمتموهن مؤمنات فلا ترجعوهن إلى الكفار لا هن حل لهم ولا هم يحلون لهن. So it's very clear. No, they would not be returned and subjected to torture and even death. And there is here a test. You know, Islam at that time was something nice, cool. A lot of teenagers jump on the wagon. And there is a chance that also some of the non-believers who Islam did not touch their hearts to jump on the wagon for worldly matters, including seeking marriage and seeking wealth. So here the test which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to ask, simple question, and he trusts their word for them to say, وَاللَّهِ مَا أَخْرَجَنَا إِلَّا حُبَّ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالْإِسْلَامِ وَمَا خَرَجْنَا لِزَوْجٍ وَلَا مَالٍ. That what made us make the migration following the believers in Yathrib, in Medina, is the love of God and His Messenger. And we did not do that, seeking marriage or wealth. And if they say that, you do not return them back to the non-believers, to idol worshippers. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Al-Walid and Umara ibn Uqba ibn Abi al-Mu'ayt that she is not going to go back. So they left. Ummu Kulthum bint Uqba was a good person, big-hearted, true believer. And here Zayd ibn Haritha radiallahu an, before Mu'ta, he came and asked for her hand. And Zayd, as you know, was like the son of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was adopted before in the Jahiliyyah as his son. And not too long after that, Zayd was martyred in the Battle of Mu'ta. And after the Idda, Az-Zubayr ibn Awam asked for her hand, and they got married. And she gave him in birth a beautiful daughter named Zainab. And she asked for divorce because of jealousy issues. And after the Idda, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu an asked for her hand, and they got married. And she brought him two sons, Ibrahim and Hamid. And Abdul Rahman ibn Auf died, and she became a widow again. And Amr ibn al-As radiallahu an asked for her hand, and they got married. And after a short while, she died and joined the hierarchy, the angels and the righteous. So this lady, we know a whole surah was revealed in her case. And we know that the test of Islam is not a long questionnaire. It is simple statement that I love God and I love His Messenger. May Allah bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.